Shall we? Let us do 3 questions. Tuck, 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 and we'll do. See, we are starting with a BCom level question. This question, no, I don't know in other university and all, departmental accounts, this is the hallmark. In Madras University examination, this question will always routine, the time after time it will be asked. And the same question with maybe every time it will be doubled or maybe half, like that, it will be the same question will come in many examinations. And most of the students know dabba the solution and present it for 8 to 10 marks, I believe. That question only our first question. Understood? The toughest question of BCom is our first question. Understood? So let us start that. For us, it is a very, very elementary question only. Are you following this? Yes. Settle down. Question number 1, page number 127. Following purchases were made by a business house having 3 departments. Everybody, the following purchases were made. Department A 1000 units, Department B 2000 units, Department C 2400 units, all at a total cost of 1 lakh. Stock on 1st January were Department A 120 units, Department B 80 units, Department C 152 units. The sales were Department A 1020 units at rupees 20 each, Department B 1920 units at rupees 22.5 each, Department C 2496 units at rupees 25. Rate of GP same in each case. Prepare department trading account. They are not even asking P&L, only trading account. So what will come in department trading account, sir, or any trading account? Opening stock, purchases, sales, closing stock, GP, over. This question will be no time again, be completed, correct, about 2 minutes. Now listen, friends, we will have the format department trading account, particulars A, B, C, particulars. Over. Format over. Opening stock, purchase, sales, closing, GP. Over. Understood? Now listen. Listen, friends. Do you have the value of the opening stock of each department? Look into the question and tell. Do you have the value of opening stock? Do we have, sir? We do not have. I don't want numbers. I want value. Trading account is not prepared based on numbers, my dear. Can I tell what is your gross profit? 20 units. That is nonsense. Are you following? A gross profit, it can be only in terms of amount. So opening stock has to be in amount. Correct? So they have given opening stock in units but not in amount. Value of opening stock not available. Correct? One out of 5 information are there. Opening stock, purchase, sales, closing stock, GP. Out of 5, 1 information are there. Okay, wow. Sorry. Do we have departmental wise purchases? Value of departmental wise purchases do we have? Sir, all the departments together, 1 lakh given. But I can't prepare the overall business. So I want a departmental wise purchase. Is it given or not given? Can we find out or not later? Is it given or not given? Not given. About 2 out of 5 missing. Sorry. Do we have sales information?
Yes, sir.
Sales value available?
Yes, sir.
Units given. Sale price given. So sale value available, sir.
Yes, sir.
Correct? So 1 out of 5 present. Understood? 2 out of 5 missing. Everybody? Sorry. Next. Do we have value of closing stock, sir? Leave alone value. Units are not given, sir. Oho. Closing stock missing. 3 out of 5 missing. Are you following? Sir, sales given, no, sir. Technically, you can get GP by GPR, sir. Ayyo. GPR missing. So, 4 out of 5 missing. We have only one item, which is, we have only sales information given. With this one information, we can't prepare trading account. So let us go to question number 2. Let us solve this. So let us decide how we can solve. Now listen, friends. Opening stock units available, sir. Purchase units also available. Opening stock plus purchase units is the total units available in the shop. From that, goods sold units available, sir. Naturally, closing stock units we can find out. Opening stock plus purchase in units is the total available units. Minus sold units will give you closing stock in units. Now listen, sir. Opening stock in units available. Purchases in units available. Closing stock also in units available. Sales value available. Correct? So I want value of opening stock, value of purchases, value of closing stock. Sir, very easy. Units there. Units value. Correct? Respond. Quantity is given. Value I want. What is that connects the quantity with value? What is the connection point for the quantity and value, sir? The price. Which price for selling? Cost price. Just tell me what is the cost price. Then everything is available. Because we have units for opening stock. Departmental wise units available. Units for purchases, units for closing stock, everything is available. Just tell me the cost price. Tuck it, tuck it, multiply. You get opening stock, purchases, closing stock. Sales already available. Tuck it, array GP. Are you following? Oh, super. Sir, but cost price, how to find out, sir? Romba simple. It is total cost prices. 1 lakh. Divided by total units happening to be 5,400. Like this when we do, that is a complete mistake. It's a big nonsense we are doing. When we take 1 lakh divided by 5,400. Why first of all it is nonsense? Because it is nonsense. Now listen. Friends, please listen. When you take 1 lakh divided by 5,400, you are making a presumption there. There is an assumption. If that assumption can be true, then you can proceed. What is that assumption, sir? What is my assumption? My assumption is, for all the departments, cost price is same. I am assuming, for department A, B and C, cost price of one unit is? Same. You assume like that, sir. Why don't you assume like that? The problem is that, if it were any other problem, I could have assumed and I would have got the answer, I would have multiplied so easily. In this question, I know that the cost price of each department is different. The cost price of each department is
different.
Why do you say like that? Because selling price of each department is different. And thereby, cost price of each department is
different.
Thereby, you can't do 1 lakh divided by 5,400. Are you following? So, sir, if selling price of each department is different, then cost price should be different, No. If selling price of each department is different, there is absolutely no need for cost price should be
different.
Then why do you say so? Because gross profit margin is same in all the departments.
Sir,
gross profit margin is same in all the department means cost price should be different, No. Even if cost gross profit margin is same, cost price can be same also. Correct, Abba? But if selling price is different and gross profit margin is same, together it comes, then cost price has to be different. Please listen. If selling price is different because of the cost price is not Selling price is different and gross profit margin is same. Naturally, cost price should be different. So one conclusion arrived. Cost price is not same. Understood? Now we should find out what is the cost price of each unit. Selling price of each department available?
Yes, sir.
Oh, selling price kum cost price kum connection, gross profit ratio. So first we will arrive at, earlier I thought directly take opening shop, purchase, sales, closing, I will get GP. But what was missing is cost price. Then we thought easily we can find out cost price 1 lakh divided by 5400. But that cannot be computed because cost price is not. So thereby I would like to now compute the gross profit ratio. First on to various items of trading account. Now focus shifted to cost price. Now focus shifted to gross profit. Sir, gross profit ratio is so simple, sir. GP by sales in 100. GP, how much, sir? Sales minus cost. Given. Listen, what you should do? Take the sales bar. 1020 into 20. 1920 into 22.5. 2496 into 25 is the total sales. Can you tell me total sales? 1,26,000 is the sales. Cost is 1 lakh if you do na. That is wrong. Listen, friends. Why I should not do like this na? Gross profit ratio, when you find, it has to be for the same quantity of units. Gross profit ratio, when you find, it has to be for the
same.
I know the sales quantity and the sale price, but I don't know the cost price of the sales quantity. Are you following? If you take sale price of sales quantity, you should take cost price of sales quantity. But I have sale value of sales quantity, but I don't have. Everything you are telling, no, which you know? I know cost price of purchases. We know cost price of. Sorry, at least now you tell. Can you know sale price of purchases?
Yes.
We can find out. We have only one cost. Cost price of the units purchased. Appo, you told that for margin purpose I want the same units. I have cost price of units purchased. I should find out sale value of units purchased. Now I have sale value of units purchased, cost price of units purchased. Both are represent same quantity, different value. That is the margin which shall be expressed on the sale value. You will get the gross profit ratio. Using that ratio, convert the selling price of each department into cost price, multiply with the different units, get opening stock, get purchases, get closing stock, then prepare trading account. Understood, Appa? Everybody, let us first make the computation for finding gross profit ratio. Everybody? Friends, be quiet. Question number 1. First, gross profit ratio. Friends, please stop talking. Let us arrive at sale value of units purchased. Sale value of units purchased. Everybody, or we will present in a table format. Three questions. Same value, yes. Morning tax class only, no. After that, how much you get, so much of energy after that class, I know. Very good. Sama Maka. Three departments on, three problems on. Rahul's Maka Joker. Please listen. Friends, please listen. Please stop talking. You're in the bed, too, you know. கொஞ்சம் டைம் கூட படுத்துருவாங்க, தூங்கிடுவாங்க. டிபார்ட்மெண்ட் ஏ பி சி யூனிட்ஸ் பர்ச்சேஸ்ட் யூனிட்ஸ் பர்ச்சேஸ்ட் 1000 2000 Department ABC Units purchased 1000 2000 2400 Selling price per unit Friends, please stop making noise. Now we are arriving at sale value of units purchased. Sale value of units purchased. Correct? These are the units purchased. This is the sale value. So thereby it is 20,000. Come on here, please. So if you sell all those units which you have purchased, this will be the sale value. Why do you find like the sale value, sir? Because I know the cost price of only these many units. So to have on equal quantity the sales and cost, I am doing this way. Understood? So arriving at the sale value of those units purchased. I had sale value of units sold, but I don't have the cost of units sold. I didn't have the cost of units sold. The only cost available in the question was cost of units. So thereby I am finding out the sale of units purchased. Could you appreciate that? Now this amount will be compared with. So this is sale value of units purchased. Right? Now we require cost of units purchased, which was given in the question as 1 lakh. So gross profit 25,000. Gross profit ratio, gross profit by sales into 100, that is 25,000 by 1,25,000 into 100. Friends, let me make a statement, you complete the statement. On sales, 20% is profit. I want the required format of mine.
Cost is 80.
That's all. Out of sales, 20% is profit, 80% is cost. So why should we express like that, sir? Now to convert the selling price into cost price, I don't want to apply 20% then deduct it. Directly apply 80%. Are you following? So instead of applying 20% and then reducing, you can directly apply 80%. Are you following this? Above here only cost price. It is cost price on sales is 80%. So thereby cost price 80% of sale price. Correct, Appa? So 80% of 2016. 80% of 22.5. 18. 80% of 25. 20. Everybody? So we will get now purchases. Here itself only we will get the actual purchases value. 1000 units purchased. 1 unit having a cost of 16 rupees. 16,000, 36,000. If you take the total, it will be 1 lakh. So the 1 lakh order breakup is this. Just two more questions. Okay. Can I turn this page? Now before I present the trading account, let me compute closing stock in units. The next computation is closing stock in units. Department A, Department B, Department C, which is opening stock in units, everything in units, 120, 152, plus purchases, 1000. 2000. Okay. This is the total units available. Minus sales. 1020. 1920. 2496. Closing stock in units 100. We got the closing stock in units. Let us also show working note instead of doing that in the trading account. Value of opening stock and closing stock. Value of opening stock and closing stock. OSK, CSK, units, value, units, value. Department cost price per unit A, B, C, 16, 18, opening stock 120, 80, 152, 100, 160, 56. Now, you can multiply and arrive at the 1920, 1440, 3040, 1600, 2880, 1120. Now all information, everything ready made available, opening stock, purchases, sales, closing stock. Let us prepare departmental trading account. Trading account போட்டுறானே. Can you turn this page, friends? Everybody? Department. A, B, C. Two opening stock. 1920. Okay. Two purchases, 16,000. Okay. Okay. 62. Friends, please stop talking. Friends, see, what is the total of these profits? 25,000. We found out the margin based on 25,000. No, wrong. This is the profit on units purchased. We didn't have any choice at that time to find out the profit on goods sold. So this is the profit on goods sold. We appreciate that. So thereby that difference does exist. Okay. Now listen, friends. See, when I told you it is a problem which is very, very elementary, like it's a BCom level question. We can't always think like a BCom degree level student. We are professional students. So naturally we should have different way of thinking. Now we go to the first operation, that what is striked as first, 1 lakh divided by some 5,400. Which we later on proved it is wrong. Everybody? Because we know departmental cost is not same. Everybody? That was decided based on the selling price being different and margin is same. And listen, friends. joint product, byproduct over.
Sorry.
Process costing and over. Over. You know, equivalent units of production. Friends, please listen. Now, I could not total this 1000, 2000, 2400 because they are representing different cost price. If I can express all in terms of one department, all in terms of one department. So for that, I need the cost price. No. Even though I don't know selling price, I know the proportion of cost price, which is the same as proportion of selling price. I repeat my discussion. Even though I do not know, now let me put the mathematical cap. It is this way. Even though I do not know the proportion of, even though I don't know the actual cost price, but I know the proportion of cost price. How do you know that, sir? It is the same as proportion of selling price. Whatever proportion you have of a selling price between these three departments, same proportion only will be here. How do you make that point, sir? Because the margin is same. Suppose there is a proportion, my dear friend. Everybody, 5:3. To this proportion, you multiply a particular number. That's small. Or you divide that by a same number. You will get the same proportion. You understand that basic rules and laws of proportion. CPD level stuff. Everybody, respond, friends. Apo, if selling price is going to be 25, 22.5 and 20. Everybody, I understand same is the proportion for cost price. Same is the proportion for cost price. Why means the margin is
same.
The difference between selling price and cost price is margin. Respond. So thereby, if you are supposed to apply that 80%, I don't know that 80% and all, correct? But I know that the same margin only will, whatever number you multiply or divide will be the same number. Correct? But naturally, the proportion of cost price will be the same proportion of selling price. Now what do we do is, let me apply that concept of equivalent units of purchase, not equivalent units of production. I'm going to express every unit in terms of department. Yeah, just an alternative thought. Shall we, sir? Yes, sir. Listen, friends. Department A, B, C. Selling price 22.5. I don't know the cost price, but I know the cost price will be in this proportion. Respond, friends. Now listen. It is equivalent units in terms of department A. Equivalent units in terms of department A. Everybody following? That is, by spending 1 lakh rupees, instead of buying the units of different department, you spend the entire money on buying one departmental units. So I am expressing everything in terms of department A. How do you express that, sir? It's very simple. One unit of department A equal to how many units of department A? One unit. Don't think. Don't take time. One unit of department A equal to how many units of department A? One unit. Are you following up? Respond. So it is 20 divided by 20. It is 1. Similarly, one unit of department A equal to how many units of, one unit of department B equal to how many units of department A? In other words, you incur more cost for which department, my dear friends? You incur more cost. No, comparing with A and B, you incur more cost for
B.
Correct? But with B's cost, you buy A, you will get more units or less units?
More.
If B order cost and you are spending for A, you will get more units or less units? You'll get more units, correct? How many units you will get? Nah, it is 22.5 by 20 because the proportion of cost to price is this. This is the proportion of cost to price. It is 1.125, which is nothing but 22.5 by 20. Understood? Similarly, the amount that I have for C, that also I am using for A units. Correct? I will get more than one unit or less than one unit? More than one unit. How it is? 25 by 20, it is 1.25. Are you following, friends? Now this is in terms of one unit. If you are not buying B, if you buy A, you will get how many units? 1.125. Similarly, for C, you will get how many units? 1.25. Now, actual units purchased. 1,000, 2,000, 2,400. Correct? Equivalent purchases of department A. 1,000. Instead of buying 2,000 units of B, if I buy A, I will get more than 2,000 or less than 2,000. For one unit K, I will get 1.125. 2,000 units K, how many units will be getting? 2,250 units of A will get. How many units? 2,250 units. Then, similarly, one unit of C equal to 1.25 units of A. 2,400 units of C equal to how many units of A? 2,000. All these are by spending 1 lakh rupees. If you buy only A units, then you will get 6,250 units. Correct? In that case, cost price per unit of department A equal to 1 lakh divided by 625. Which operation you prohibited me here, the same operation I will do. Understood? This only we thought not to be done like this and all, but we are going to do that one day. So not 5,400. So it is like this. We got cost price of department A. Correct? For B, like this one table. For C, another table. Not required, because we know the proportion of cost price. We know the proportion of cost price. Correct? So thereby, cost price, this is 16 into 1.125, 18 into, I'm sorry, 16 into 1.25, 20. Are you all following this? Where without finding gross profit ratio, I never found out GPR here, but I got the cost price. Now with this cost price, I can easily find out opening stock, purchase, sales, closing stock, everything. I will get GP. Correct? So here, whatever work we have done, finding gross profit ratio absolutely avoided by this equivalent units working. Understood? Appa? See, when they solve only solution of one method, which is dabba, professionals not like that, can think in any other ways. Yes, sir. Everybody? Understood? Yes, sir. Now listen, friends. See, you know that units purchases 1,000, 2,000. This is the sale price. The same is the proportion of cost. Now if you multiply now, sir, this actually represent proportion of cost. This is the proportion of cost for purchased units. Are you following? Without even finding GPR, I can find out directly purchases in this proportion. I repeat, my dear friends, without even finding GPR, this is a combined weight of units purchase and selling price. Selling price proportion, the cost price proportion. So without doing any other computation, what I can do now? 1 lakh into 20,000 by 1,25,000. 1 lakh is the total cost, pa. That 1 lakh I will apportion in this proportion, pa. 20,000 is to 45,000 is to 60,000. Not in this proportion. So what is that? 1 lakh into 20,000 divided by 1,25,000. How much you get? 16,000. 1 lakh into 45,000 by 1,25,000. 36,000. 48,000. You get purchases. You know, actual units purchased. That way also you will get cost price per unit. It is not one or two. We can think in as many methods for that matter. Understood, Appa? Everybody, it's not one way of arriving at the answer. You have to think, you should apply. Understood.